Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining us for a quick start guide for getting started with your TracerPlus trial. Today, I'm going to kind of walk you through getting started with deploying a simple application over to the handheld on, in my case, an iOS device here, but the deployment process for an Android device would be just the same. So you can see here on the screen, I have my TracerPlus mobile client, which again is running on an iPhone, iOS-based device. And in the background, I have TracerPlus desktop. So after you sign up for your trial, you just want to make sure that you open the application and sign in to TracerPlus, as well as download and install the TracerPlus desktop utility, which is a free-to-use tool that's available from TracerPlus.com. Once you step through the quick installation process, you'll see and be presented with the home screen of TracerPlus as you see it here behind my iOS device. So with that, let's get started. You can see on my handheld screen here, I have a fire extinguisher inspection application that I already have deployed, but let's say I want to go ahead and create something from scratch and deploy it to the handheld. So to do that, I'm going to jump over to TracerPlus desktop and start a new project. When I do that, you'll see I started project one with a session one, which is one form within our project that we can go ahead and configure for our whatever need we might need to use TracerPlus for on your handheld. So I'm going to go ahead and name this something, and let's just say we're going to do an asset tracking session on our handheld. So we want to track assets using our iOS device or Android device and deploy it to the handheld so a mobile worker can go out and start collecting that data. So I'll go ahead and name my form asset track, and now I'm going to start configuring the fields that I'd like to collect. Now I'm going to do something very simple here because really I just want to show you how to deploy your projects to the handheld and make those changes and then see how they behave on the handheld itself. So I'll go ahead and maybe name the first field barcode. Maybe the second field will be description, and the third field maybe just a date timestamp. We just want to capture these three fields of information on our form. Very simple. And the only thing I'll configure with my application here is I'm going to change the date time to be data type of a date time. Now I'll leave the rest as defaults, but what you can see here is you can really configure all of the attributes of all of the fields that you're collecting on the handheld, and you would just fill this out to all of the data that you would like to collect on your device. So maybe you're collecting RFID tags, the description, condition type fields, dropdowns, checkboxes, all that sort of fun stuff, you would go ahead and configure in TracerPlus. But I'm just going to leave this as a simple application to really show the deployment process. But before I do that, I'll just jump in and mention the form designer. This is where you're actually creating what the forms look like on the handheld. So you're changing the colors of the forms, the layout of the forms, what fields are visible to the user, and just really kind of customizing it to your application. And this is what the person on the device would be using as they go ahead and scan assets for this particular form here. But let's just say I'm done. So I have my application set up, my asset track. I'm collecting barcode, description, and date time for the user, and I want to deploy this to the handheld. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and hit the build deploy button down on the bottom, and then just click deploy when this pop-up comes up and overwrite the existing application if you have one. And what that does is it generates a QR code. So you can see that here. It's a QR code that I need to scan on the device side. So let me jump back over to my iPhone. Now to get this application that I just configured on the handheld, I'm going to click this menu button up at the top left of the screen, which opens up my main menu, and then I'm going to go ahead and click download project. When I do that, I want to go ahead and scan the QR code. So I'm going to click the scan QR code option right here, and then the use camera option that pops up from this dialog. And that'll go ahead and load the camera to scan the QR code. So I'm just going to go ahead and aim this camera at the QR code. It scans it, decodes it, and downloads our project right to the handheld. And we can go ahead and see our changes now. So if I were to show you, again, I have that barcode description and date time field. And if I on the handheld, I open up my asset tracking form, you can see I have exactly what I set up within TracerPlus desktop. So everything you configure within TracerPlus desktop, just always go back to the build deploy option, generate the QR code, click the menu, scan the QR code, and it will download the project to the handheld, and you can begin using it to collect data within TracerPlus on your iPhone or Android-based device. Before I go here, I just wanted to mention that for trial users, we do have a samples section available on the home screen of TracerPlus desktop. So if you're new to the software, new to the applications, you can go ahead and jump over to the samples area here, and it kind of has pre-built applications that might fit what you're looking to do. So maybe you're doing some type of mobile inspections application. You can go to the mobile inspections category, scroll down, take a look at the different options here. You can go ahead and finish the import option here. It downloads it from our website to TracerPlus desktop and opens it up upon completion. So you can go ahead and change it if you'd like, or just use it as it is. So you can see this one here for fire extinguisher inspections I have on the TracerPlus desktop. And now just like the forms that I created myself, I will always go back to build deploy, hit the deploy button, which will generate the QR code. I can make this bigger, and now I can go back over to my form and I can download the project by hitting the menu button, download project, use camera, and then scan that QR code. It will download the new configuration to my iPhone. And if I take a look at this on the screen here, you can see it's this extinguisher inspection. If I were to open it up, it looks like what we have configured in TracerPlus desktop. So again, any changes you make in TracerPlus desktop, just generate the QR code and scan it. And you'll have access to it on the handheld side. And that's how easily you can deploy to the handheld. These sample applications you can configure and change as you need them, or just kind of look around at them to see how some of the features are set up within TracerPlus desktop. It's a good learning tool for the application. So with that, it's all I wanted to show you for this quick start guide, but I hope you get the most that you can out of the TracerPlus trial. If you do have any questions during your trial period, please feel free to reach out to us. We'd be glad to get feedback as well as any questions you may have. So thanks again, everyone, and good luck.